Hi everyone, it is Carol CC Miller, your positivity trainer, peace activator, and global hugger. And today I wanted to talk about memories and how we go about creating good memories. And hi Ellen, glad you're joining me. And so we're going to talk about, again, about memories. This past weekend, I mentioned it before, I volunteer here in Chicago with an organization called Judd Goldman Adaptive Sailing Program. And we take people out who are handicapped and teach them how to sail. Now, there is a variety of different physical disabilities people have that join the program. We have blind people or hard of seeing people join. Many people who have been stroke survivors, and so they may have some physical disabilities in their bodies because of the stroke or different illnesses that create different physical disabilities. And it has been a pleasure to be involved with this organization for 6 years. This past weekend, we had a big regatta, and there were people in from all over the country and all over the world competing in this disabled adaptive sailing program regatta. And this one gentleman at the end, who I believe he came in second in his area, I don't recall exactly, but he mentioned when he was accepting his award, something that he lives by that I thought was a really impacted me, and it was a really good thing to think about on how we create memories. So I'm going to read that to you, and then let's discuss that. So creating memories. Make one memory today that will last a week. Make one memory this week that will last a month. Make one memory this month that will last a year. And make one memory this year that will last a lifetime. And I just thought that was so powerful. And sometimes we get so caught up in the day-to-day grind and the busyness of the day that we stop focusing on the fact that in each moment we are creating a new memory. And we get to choose if it's a good memory, if it's a happy memory, if it's a sad memory, if it's an angry memory. I mean, we have all those feelings for a reason, so I'm not asking you not to ever feel sad or angry. I certainly had experiences of that. But we get to choose how we feel. We get to choose how long we want to stay in those spaces. So when I thought about it, I'm like, this gentleman, I actually spoke to him, and I don't know his age. I'm guessing he's in his 40s. He said 15 years ago he lost his sight from a degenerative disease that he had, and it was gone within 5 months. So the majority of his life he had sight, and then all of a sudden it was gone. And he learned, I mean, I'm sure he went through the why me and the anger and all that that we go through when we're facing a challenge that seems bigger than us. But he has created an amazing life. He sails, he works, he travels the world doing what he loves, creating memories. So I'm curious to you who are joining me today, if there's any type of memories, like some happy memories that you think of. I was just talking to somebody the other day about my dad who transitioned 11 years ago. And it's a silly, happy memory for me. But when I was a child, my mom was always the one who would buy the school clothes and everything. And there were a particular pair of shoes that I wanted desperately. They were platform shoes. As you know, I'm not very tall. And there was no way on earth she was going to buy them for me because they weren't practical. They weren't comfortable and could be dangerous because they were such high heels. So what did I do? I went shopping with my dad one day, and he got them for me. And then the next week when I went to school, I stepped off the school bus, twisted my ankle, and broke my foot because of wearing those shoes. So obviously there was pain involved in that memory. But there was some anger with my mom about me and my father because of that memory. But it's something that's going to last a lifetime of a connection with my dad on being able to, like, go around and get him to help me out. And it's just, it's a fun memory for me to think about now. I do focus my day on appreciation. So when I'm creating memories, it's through appreciation that I'm focusing on to create that memory. I'm going to be going to Croatia in September. So I know my year memory for a lifetime will be that trip. But I really do try to focus on creating memories that I want to remember. And that includes the sad ones. When my dad passed away, it was certainly very sad. But it also brought up a lot of happy memories of my childhood with him, or disagreements that we had that were, we were very different politically, but we could have those conversations and still do it in a loving manner, even though we completely disagreed with each other on many aspects of a political realm. So I'd love to know. Hi, Sylvia. Thanks for joining from London. Hi, Janny. It's good to see you. Good timing as well. Thank you. And Jeffrey Maturi, I hope I said your name right. And thank you, Carolyn and Ellen, for joining. So if you have some thoughts on how you want to create new memories, I think a lot of times we think of memories as big ticket items. I used to be the person, and I still like having something to look forward to. Don't get me wrong. But I used to be the person, if I did not have something big coming up to look forward to, like I was disappointed and frustrated and not happy. It's like, well, what am I going to do with the rest of the month or the week or the year kind of thing? And so I always plan to have something, a month out, or I'm a pretty instantaneous person. So 6 months out is way too long for me. And so I used to plan it where, I'm going to be doing this in a month. And that was a memory that I was looking forward to. The more I focus my life on appreciation, and again, I still love, like, I'm going to go see Michael Fronte in concert in a couple weeks. And if you guys don't know who he is, I will post a link to his music because he's phenomenal. And he's even better live than he is on the albums. But he's all about love and kindness. So he's totally my kind of guy. And so I'm really looking forward to that. But I'm also looking forward to today. I'm looking forward to tomorrow. Today, one of my clients, I've had a really busy project that started this week. So it's been a bit hectic. But it's still my choice to focus on it being a good memory and thinking about the process of it occurring and how each day, each minute actually offers us the opportunity to step deeper into love. And I was talking, Ellen here is with me today, and I was talking to her earlier. And so that was one of my good memories for today, is that I got a chance to talk to my friend Ellen. And sometimes when you're being called to focus on love, it's often because of a painful or a challenging situation where we get the choice to be bitter about what took place, or we get the choice to open up and expand because of what took place. I kind of think that love isn't for the faint of heart, and I'm not even talking romantic love, just being a loving person, because it's so easy to step into fear and wanting to protect ourselves from being hurt from many, many different experiences that go out there. So choose memories today. I'd love for you to really think about what the sailor said. Make one memory today that will last a week. So today is Tuesday, at least here in Chicago. I know in Australia you're in Wednesday already. So what today, just think about as you go through the day, what you're going to remember about today. What is it, what brought you a smile to your face today? What made you laugh today? Maybe what made you cry today? Sometimes tears are releasing of sadness, but they're also a release of happiness. I know I tear up when I see any sentimental video on Facebook or something. I'm usually crying about those kinds of things. So ask yourself, what kinds of things today do you want to take forward in your memory bank? Because our memory is, I mean, it's in there. So if you're focusing today on things that bring you sadness and anger and frustration and that you're not worthy of, that gets stored in your memory too. And that's going to create future memories for you to move forward with. So today, what is it about today that you're excited to take into your tomorrow? What is it this week? Is it going to be that memory that you take into your month? What is it this month? We're August 1st. And what is it this month that's going to create something of a memory that you're excited to take into the next year until August of next year? And then this year, what is it that's going to last with you for a lifetime? Now, I suspect the more you focus on creating memories, you're going to have lots of them. It's not going to just be one, and they're going to be different sizes. Some of it's going to be just remembering a laugh with a friend. Some of it's going to be you've got great news that you're going to remember that day because of the great news you had. So really step into appreciation. And as I was talking with Ellen, and I asked her to be on the show at a different time, we haven't set it up yet, but to really focus starting your mornings in it. So I'm going to start keeping a journal in the mornings on what do I appreciate. And it might be three things when I first wake up. I am not a morning person, so this will be a good challenge for me to step into this practice, but to really start my day off in appreciation. Now, before I get out of bed, I do that anyway, but writing it down just adds it gets it out of your body and gets it more, even a different type of focus. So I am going to work on the journaling aspect. So I'd really love to see what you guys are trying to create. Please always feel free to share them here in these comments or any of the comments on the Facebook page, because I'm really here to help heighten celebrations and lessen sorrows. We all go through things in our life that make us happy, and we all go through things in our life that make us sad. And if we do them together, our celebrations will be much higher and our sorrows will be much less because of the collaboration and the support that we are here for each other, and simply the kindness that we are here for each other. So create kind memories. So Jenny, focus on what you want. Yes, that's a definite good one. And I would encourage you to do so when you're in an experience of something that you don't want, and it's through awareness, because it's easy to get into that blame or complain, but immediately say, or not even immediately, but think about it once you're getting into that, I can't believe that this is happening, I don't want this to happen, to then go into what do I want? And I was just talking with Ellen about different experiences that I've had in my life that in that moment, I didn't want it, I didn't like it, and I didn't think it was fair that it was happening to me. And yet, down the road, I see how it has made me a stronger person. It's actually made me a kinder person. It made me a more confident person because of that experience. In the moment, certainly didn't like it, didn't want it, but I know that all of the experiences that I go through, the really good ones and the really challenging ones, are here to serve me rather than to hinder me. Sometimes in the moment of challenge, I forget that and go into the it's hindering me part. So Ellen, connecting with you today filled my heart too, and she's getting ready to meet some college friends in Florida. I'm excited for her. Sylvia, I'm household due to health issues, housebound. So I always make sure to have a visitor at least once a week just to keep the connection from the outside world. Really appreciate having family come home in the evenings to find their days. What good advice. Time seemed to whiz by and need memories to anchor our day. Time does go so quick. I can't believe we're already in August. It feels like I just said Happy New Year a month ago. So Sylvia, I think those are great things to do, and I know that you join me here, which I so appreciate, and you've been on another friend's lives too. So even connecting, I know people think that being the social media is taking us out of connecting in truth in person, but I know people from all over the world because of social media. So if you're able to find that connection, reach out to those people as well. Sylvia, one of my biggest things is music. I listen to it all the time. If I'm in a sad mood, sometimes I'll listen to sad music because I need to feel that for a little bit, but then I'll put on music that inspires me or music that makes me just simply happy. So you might look into some of those things and to really focus on what you're grateful for in your house, since you have some health issues that are keeping you housebound. You know, look around your house and point out what you appreciate about it. I would encourage you to point out what you appreciate about your health and really start focusing on the aspects of your health. Like, and I don't know your experience and your story, so I don't know what you're going through, and you don't even need to share it. That's not the point, but I have a family member who cannot breathe on their own well, so they have 24/7 oxygen, and it's keeping them healthy, and I'm so grateful and appreciative of that. But it reminds me that it's so easy for us to not appreciate things that seem to be natural. So because of my family member's health experience, That's one of the things I appreciate daily, is that I'm breathing on my own. Sometimes, you know, like I'll get a stuffy nose or something from allergies, but guess what? I'm still breathing on my own. So that's something that I like to focus on. So if you are going through a challenge right now, bring it back to the basics on what you can appreciate. Because when you're focusing on what you appreciate in your life, then you're creating those memories from a space of appreciation. And bonus points for you when you can appreciate and focus on the appreciation in the challenge. Because I promise you, it is there. It's there for us to choose to see. It doesn't always come easily, and sometimes we want to stay in the blame or victim because that's a safe feeling rather than taking responsibility of our own happiness. Because really, we are responsible for our own happiness. I've said it many times, and I'll continue to say it. Others enhance or detract from our experience, but we are the ones who make it. I believe Wayne Dyer said, if you're happy with your own company, then you'll never be alone. So I think that's a really good one as well. Hi, Michael. Good to see you. And Zanine, I hope I said your name correctly. Praise to be God. I think when people have a deep faith that keeps them in enjoying life, it's a beautiful thing. So thank you for sharing that. So again, I just want to go back to creating memories and what that sailor taught me on Sunday. And here's a person, again, I live in appreciation. But what he broke it down into on what today, what can I create today that's going to stay with me for the week? What memory? What are you going to create a memory this week that's going to stay with you for the month? What memory are you going to create this month that's going to stay with you for the year? And what memory are you going to create this year that's going to last a lifetime? And the more you focus on creating happy, kind, loving, considerate, fun memories, the more you're going to be like, I have so many to choose from. I don't just have one. But it starts somewhere. So start with yourself on creating from a space of appreciation, from creating from a space of kindness, and from creating from a space of love. Because if we're seeking kindness and love and consideration and compassion in the world, we need to be that first. We need to be the ones who emulate that. So because each of us are creating our world memories. If we all take responsibility for creating peace in our own life, for creating love in our own life, for creating happiness in our own life, for creating kindness in our own life, then we are going to create that in the world as well. So I really would love to keep hearing about your memories. As a matter of fact, I'm going to be back on Thursday with Dr. Cheryl, and we're going to be talking about the importance of rest and relaxation in our lives, because we do live in such a busy, busy life. So we'll be talking about that. So if you're here with me today, I definitely would love to see you on Thursday, and then I want to hear some memories that you've created for the week, or maybe even there's some that you're thinking about creating, like I just told you. In a couple of weeks, August 11th, if you're in Chicago, Michael Fronte is here, and I am so excited to see him. That is one of my memories that I'm really excited about. Obviously, I'll be going to Croatia. We have one more on-deck cabin left. If you want to create that memory with me, we'll be there for 10 days. Seven of them is on a small cruise ship. Their biggest cruise ship, we haven't been assigned what boat we'll have yet, but their biggest one only holds 40 people, and we're not all 40 people. I wanted this first group to be a small group, and so there will be other people on the ship with us as well. But it's from 32 people to 40 people on these small cruises. So just think of the memories that will be created there, and I'll be hopefully doing lives from Croatia in early September as well. So thank you very much for joining me. I totally forgot, as I have been lately, to say if you're in the need of a hug, to put where you're joining me from, because I'm here to share virtual hugs with you, because hugs heighten celebrations and they lessen sorrow. So that is what I'm here for, is to remind you that you matter. You matter to me, you matter to the world, and most importantly, you matter to you. So go out there and create a magical, magical day, and turn that into a magical week, turn that into a magical month, turn that into a magical year, and then turn that into a magical lifetime, and share it. Share your love and kindness and compassion with yourself, with your friends, with your family, and with the world. We'll talk again on Thursday. Bye-bye for now.